Hi guys.
Hello people. In the middle of me closing this. Do you just like wait for the space where I'm like not prepared and be like, hi.
Hello. It's me.
Who are you?
I'm Milena.
Hello.
Hey, who are you?
It's me.
I'm Jessica.
Hi guys.
Oh, are we gonna cut off? Hello people.
We're watching Haikyuu. We're watching the man.
You can tell that by the smiles on our faces.
Yes.
Although maybe you couldn't because like we start every episode right now with a smile because
that's true. It's all good. Yes, but like
you have to explain this now.
No, because you said you can tell by the smiles on our face. I understood you. You can tell by the smell.
By the smell.
I was like, what? God, these intros. I'm very excited.
I'm so excited.
We're watching the match.
We're watching the match against the school something on N.
And we met...
Kenma
and...
It's four letters. It's something short. Like, not Fuji.
It's not Fuji.
I don't think it's even close to that.
I don't think it has any...
Hajin. I know. I honestly think I'm making this up. Okay. I don't even think it's close. Yeah. Keji. There's no way it's like, Kenma and Keji.
I thought it was okay. I'm probably mistaken.
I don't know. I just know Kenma voice actor is Eren Yeager.
Really?
Every episode, I wonder what the voice actor is going to be because I feel like everyone is an actor that we know.
Yeah.
Rainer, I think there's Rainer's voice actor as well.
Interesting how I don't notice it at all. I think because
they do their jobs well.
Yes.
I don't know. Sometimes it's like I can hear Kage.
Who is Kage?
Kage is Hinata.
Hinata. I need to listen now.
I can hear it.
Because Kage has a specific voice.
Yeah, but like you can hear it in like Kage's is more rougher. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know, but you can hear it in bits when Hinata is like...
Okay, I'm really wondering because like I think in my opinion, it's like I would recognize a voice. But like I think is it like different because it's Japanese and I don't speak Japanese at all. So like maybe that's why I would not be able because like if it was an American English, whatever...
Like Invincible.
Exactly, Sandra. I could not have missed it. Like, I think even Gus at one point we recognized. Was Gus, he playing somebody?
Gus, yeah. Yeah, he was.
You know, like, I feel like I recognize many times some voices, you know?
I don't.
I even remember there was, what was the show? Like, Mr. Robot, there was a guy from season one, you know? Like, it was like in two episodes or something, and then he showed up later at the end of season two. Or this probably is not correct by the episodes or seasons. But like we heard him before we saw him and I knew who was coming because I recognized the voice.
I'm useless at that. I remember you when you were watching Attack on Titan like in season 4 when Eren was like hiding as that soldier that came back or whatever. Before we knew it was him, you wanted to say that that guy sounds like Eren.
Remember You're that? Lying. No.
No, I remember really? That.
I don't remember.
You said that like you recognized his
What's
voice.
What's the problem then? Why don't you like, recognize any single one of them? Is Hisoka playing the guy?
We recognize Hisoka. Yeah, Hisoka is.
I mean, we didn't recognize it. Somebody wrote it and then.
Yeah, but like it's so clearly. Yeah. Because like I forgot. Yeah. I didn't remember because like people wrote.
Many of them.
So many of them, like whose voice actors are coming or whatever. But like the second that he started speaking, you hear Hisoka.
That's true.
Like that is a very clear one.
Maybe depending on how they change their voice as well. You know, maybe I just need to an actor with a specific voice, like recognizable. You know, because the Hisoka has a in my opinion, recognizable.
I don't know,
voice.
But like think again, the voice actor is gonna use different types of like voice for different characters. That's why we're not voice actors. I mean, like Eren and Kenma seems like two spectrums of people.
Yeah.
You know, like Eren spent half the time yelling.
Yeah.
And Kenma is very calm.
Oh, yes, come on.
That's what I mean.
We're not gonna be able to hear.
That's what I mean. I'm gonna search for it. I don't know.
Kenma's very cute. He's very cute. He's very adorable. I saw people like him as a single character.
Literally, as per usual, a new character appears. Five people in our comments. Here's my favorite character. At this point, I'm just like, any new character, someone's gonna write that. And what a joy.
I'm excited to meet him. See him again in this episode. I'm very excited about this match, honestly.
Yeah. I, as always, think we're gonna lose. Every time I think we're gonna lose, and somehow we have won so far. So now we definitely have to lose. You've just won so
every
much.
Every single...
But I'm kind of rooting for the other team as well, because, like, you know, Kenma was saying how people don't think that he... let's say, is a good setter because he doesn't appear as such, because a setter is like a pillar of the team and he maybe does not look that way. And so, like, I'm rooting for them as well. Seem very cute and sweet.
Yeah, I mean, if the game against Hinata and against our other boys as well, like, is something that, like, is gonna brought that joy of the game out of Kenma.
Yeah.
Like, that's more than a win, in my opinion.
Yeah, I mean, I don't care. Like, I honestly don't care who wins and who loses. Either. I'm just like, every time I say about our guys, I think they're gonna lose. So I just have to put one last bit there to see if they're gonna lose.
Yeah, I don't care either.
I'm very excited.
I do excite them too.
And I think they're trying out their new, how the fuck do you call it? Their new positions within the team. And I want to see how that works for them. I think that's going to be fun.
Me too.
So, I'm very excited. We're watching episode 12.
Yeah.
I'm going to watch 12 and then we're gonna watch 13.
Very excited.
Let's play. Why did we start whispering?
I always wonder that.
The Neko Karasu reunion.
And next one is Rival.
They're rivals.
Yeah. I'm guessing that's just both of them are the game. We're going to watch both of them.
Yes. So, okay.
Playing one and after the one.
I think I understood what we meant when we said we're playing 12 and 13.
But you're getting one.
Doesn't matter to you. It's just that our viewing experience could potentially be better because we're not cutting it off.
Exactly.
In the middle of a match.
Exactly. 5 years ago. Oh my god.
Oh, the coach. Okay. Mm-hmm. Out of the garbage. Well, I think neither of our teams are now like...
Yeah.
I root for both of them. To make it far.
Adorable.
Oh, they're so cute. Look at this.
You're so fucking adorable. You're so cute. Oh my god, so excited! And crow.
I mean, I prefer cats to crows, but...
Definitely.
I prefer our boys, crows.
Yeah, I prefer cats to crows in real life.
Yeah,
course,
but like in
as
fiction.
As a symbol, I feel like I would prefer a crow.
Yeah.
Sounds more interesting. Though.
Sex of crows.
Exactly.
Come on.
Dual or Kageyama. I love Kageyama.
I
love Kageyama.
Before there says something or Kageyama. I adore Kageyama.
Me too.
Kageyama is right now my number one.
Mine too. But like I think that, I mean...
Again, I feel like this could
stop my mind. It's stop my mouth, but like I feel like for him, I think it doesn't have to change somehow.
No, it really might not. I love those angry ones, but like he is very sweet. Like
angry ones for sweet, not the angry ones for just
angry
and not sweet.
He is honestly, he is only yelling at everyone else.
I mean, he
very,
was yelling
like,
at others as well when he was
in
rude,
his
but
previous
he's not
team, yeah.
rude anymore.
I would kind of like to see when they become like second year or whatever, how he would be for first years.
Yeah.
I feel like he would be a good mentor. Kenma looks like a cat a bit.
Yeah.
He's not a man of many words.
Well, he saw the t-shirt.
This is their Tanaka. This is their Tanaka. Literally.
Yeah.
Here's our... They're the same. That other guy in their lineup also had like a higher chin. City boy. Are we like from a village? Like what are we from?
That's their Suga. I cannot. Girl, I'm on your side.
Do you have other friends beside me?
Kyuan,
Did you figure out who he reminds you of?
I know.
This one is cute. Very sweet. He looks like an emo tough guy, but he's so sweet.
What is happening?
The high one told them to win. Well, he said that so honestly. He's just like, he's like, you should. That would be beneficial to us.
That's true. That's what we found out about their team.
They said that they have little like holes in their game. Open your eyes, my boy. Good job. He's so cute. Maybe like this motivates him to try also.
Okay, we're definitely winning.
We're very
so far.
Good, but he's paying attention.
Yeah.
That's true.
He knows him by his name. You are being watched and
but literally that's like Kenma seems to just be paying attention and biding his time until he figures out where and how to hit. I mean, he is a setter. That is gonna be his job. At the beginning we have the element of surprise, but then they can adapt. That's that libido. I was on the right hand to do this more often. Dump. Is that the name of that? Dump? Interesting! Let's go. I'm not used to seeing him.
Yes. Oh my god, I want to die, he's teaching him.
While yelling a bit.
Him.
He wants him to live up to his full potential. Yeah. Good boy.
Love that for Tsuki. Complete opposite.
I mean, yeah.
I know, but like,
he just goes and attacks, closes his eyes and like... Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. I adore him.
Did he just do selfie? Where the fuck is the camera going?
I'm gonna die now.
I love them. I hope we see them win something, like some competition. Someone said there's Haikyuu on Netflix as well. But like, everyone always says the translation on Netflix is shit.
For this show?
I don't know.
Maybe it's the same for this
show. Tell me, guys. Maybe it's the same. I love the bravery. My boy, that is so fucking brave. You opened your eyes. I never thought I'd be this happy
for a guy. I was shocked.
But he kept trying, and when it counted, he got him. Yes, my boy. Exactly.
I want to die. I'm gonna cry now.
This song is the song that gets me most. I've been listening to it, I cry at it. なんでひなたを交代させないのかって言いたいのか。別に。これが公式戦なら変えてるかもな。でも今なら解決策を探すチャンス。だから、ひなたが戦意を喪失してしまうようなら撤回された方がいいかもな。
高校でも月島の高さに全然勝てなくて唯一で最強の攻撃それがたった一人のブロッカーに止められた気力を挫く人の壁腕が打っただけ心は折れて
お前のトスとあと、なんかの工夫で打ち抜けるんじゃないかって思うんだ。だからもう一回、俺にトス上げてくれ。当たり前だ。あいさー!
go to Elsa.
This is why we need a coach! This is why we need a coach! That's when you need to open our eyes. So pissed off. I want to see that little giant. What a sweet boy. Don't you just love them all?
Yes, I love everything.
Don't you just love them all?
Thank God we're gonna watch the next episode.
This is the most unrealistic show I've seen in my life.
I agree.
Like
Attack on Titan, more realistic than this.
Well, that was very realistic. That was a sad part of it. Like, what is...
No, I'm talking about the Titans part.
Yeah,
of it, you
the
know?
Flying giants.
Exactly.
More realistic. Like...
I completely agree.
I was on the volleyball team. We wanted to kill each other across the net. I have never seen these people before in my life. We were like about to kill each other. For the first time, I need to speak to the parents in an anime. And say nice words. Like, I need to see these people and congratulate them.
I mean, that was also
every single one.
Mob Psycho.
Very
I
true.
I mean, God, I love this episode. I adore this episode. Adored everything in this episode.
As always, our every review, the same. Again, I expected a lot from Haikyuu going into it. I expected to love it. Because I expected most of these things. And I got them. Like, I was like, we're gonna have this team. And we're gonna see them play and everything, but like, I didn't account for the other teams that we're gonna fight against, that they're gonna flesh them out.
Yes.
I didn't think about that because, like, I can love 12 of them, but now I'm gonna have to love like 30 of them. You know what I mean? Like, with every new team and with every new introduction, I'm gonna have to like love so many of them and root for so many of them.
Like, I honestly wanted to die when we saw Kenma and Kuro's friendship. I wanted to die in that moment.
You know what I mean? Like, how am I not following them
like,
as well?
Exactly, because, like, we see Kenma and how he is.
I loved the explanation of his character, because like, I think it's very relatable. Like, he... Like, is not, let's say, very social. He is not good with people. He is, like... I mean, he says that he's not good with people. Like, he is introverted. So, like, he's not, you know... He's not gonna maybe strike up a conversation with you. And maybe doesn't feel all that comfortable, you know, doing that. And so, but like, he is super aware of what people think of him. That can be very anxiety inducing, I think.
Yeah, because he cares for what people think of him.
Yeah.
Like, that causes him anxiety. Just like thinking about it, you know?
Yeah, I mean, like, that doesn't help that he is not, like, let's say, a social butterfly. And the only friend that he had growing up was, like, what did they say, neighbor? Or, like, someone that lives close by?
Yeah, okay.
Kuro? Sunshine?
I love him.
I love those characters. That's what I said, like, for Hinata. Hinata is the exact same way. Hinata is that extroverted character that's gonna, like, take you under his wing. You know what I mean? Like, you don't have to speak much. You don't have to speak fucking at all. Hinata's gonna have you covered. And, like, it seems like Kuro, or whatever, was that friend that Kenma needed. Like, that was gonna...
He came up to him.
Yeah, that was gonna push him. Take him to social situations and, like... He made them enter a volleyball team, and he really kind of liked it.
Yes, but like, he also encouraged him, and like, he made him comfortable in those types of situations, and he praised him, you know?
Yeah.
Like, he told him what Kenma needed in those moments to continue being there and to continue coming to those games and talking to other people and things like that.
Yeah, and it's not like Kenma is now a new person, totally comfortable. Like, we see, like, when he was speaking to Hinata, he was talking about how, like, he's still not sure how he feels about volleyball, but, like, his teammates need him. And so, like, he is gonna...
He's finding his place there.
Yeah, and, like, what a sweet fucking boy. I love him.
I love him.
I love him
so much. I adore him, and, like, I just, like, that friendship with Kuro, just, like, I adore that, because he was a safe space for him, safe place. And I, like, he helped him out so much.
See what I mean? Like, we had, like, 2 minutes.
No, that was my favorite part.
2 minutes of their storyline, and now I'm like,
no,
I love you.
Yeah, in that moment, I honestly
And I love Kuro. We don't know nothing about the guy. But, like, I know this one bit.
Yeah.
And that makes me love him, and he seems just, like, such a... As fucking all of them. He seems like such a well-adjusted... Honestly, Tsuki is the most realistic character. Tsuki with his comment, kind of most realistic. Being a bit of an asshole, you know, but just like...
You always have some of those
in
high school. You know?
That's what I mean.
But like,
he seems more realistic.
I do believe, like, in my opinion, like, sports, like, people can be very competitive, but like, people can be also very encouraging.
I think, you know, when you have love for the sport.
That's what I think as well. Like, I don't think... I think it isn't realistic that some of these boys are very well-adjusted and, like, very, very mature and things like that. You know, like, they speak like they lived more than they did, you know?
Yeah.
But, like, I... And as much as in some situations, like, you want to destroy your opponent and, like, win and, like, tear them down or whatever, you know? I do believe that, like, there are so many encouragement in the sport, you know, and that can help you love the sport and things like that, you know?
Yeah. I mean, considering how everyone in the team is, I don't see how you cannot fall in love with the sport. Like, you can enter that gym without a care for volleyball. Like, you cannot, and you don't have to care about it any sort of way, but, like, I feel like it would take you 10 minutes of playing with this group. And, or honestly, just like speaking to Hinata,
I agree,
to find so much passion in it, because, but, like, they... I love how much they love it.
Yeah, but, like, I think that's what sports are. That's why I think it was one of the previous episodes when, like, he said it, like, or somebody said it, like, he loves being with his friends, let's say, there, you know, and that is something that brings them joy.
Yeah.
And, like, I just think that is true, you know? Like, that is what sport can bring to many people, you know? Like, it doesn't have to be just, like, that such a big love for the moment when you're playing that sport. It just, like, it can come from a friendships and time you spend with those people as well.
I mean, I think that's the best aspect of sports. And I don't think it's necessarily always true. Like, there are many team sports where, like, clearly there is someone that, or multiple people that think themselves more important in the group and that have, like, a bigger ego. Sometimes things like that do function, let's say, but I don't think it makes it, I don't think it makes for a good environment to play in,
I
you
agree.
know? And I think, I don't think that's like, I think that's more common than like this, than having this such a healthy, honest environment. And maybe it's because like they are in high school, you know, and they're just like playing for the passion of it.
Yeah.
I think maybe when you like enter into like professional sports and getting paid and everything, things
I
like,
think so as well.
You know, then it's not, you're not doing it for passion, you're
yeah,
doing it for
I
money.
Completely agree.
And so like,
because like, let's say, like, I remember when I was swimming, you know, like, I can't say I like specifically loved the sport, you know, it was boring to me in many occasions, but like my favorite parts were competitions. My favorite parts was like spending time with the friends that like I made there. Like I really loved that aspect of the sport, you know, like, and even in the competitions I remember loving like swimmers who I met there, you know, like having time of my life there even though I lost. Always, like every,
it didn't matter.
Every
competition,
yeah,
rally,
yeah. I don't know how it's said in English. I lost them all,
yeah,
not all, but like, you know, but like I enjoyed. Like my favorite memories are of those times I had, in
yeah,
those moments. So like, maybe that's why I really love that, because like maybe I see myself in that, you know, because I enjoyed the friendships that I made.
I mean, I think they're showing you like what it should be, the best aspect of it. Of sports, of playing with a team, of just like doing it together. I think NACO, school, whatever, I think they have a better, an even better grasp on that maybe than our guys. I mean, they have been, I guess, playing together a bit longer than our guys. But like they really, they have that unity, and they were talking about like they have to like stay connected. Basically like that something about blood flowing like through all of them so that they are like connected fully, and that's how they can operate on the field, and not field, on the, what is English, Terren, it, I'm,
court,
I, court, I guess maybe because like I played it, and I played it in Serbia, you know,
yeah,
I don't know
weird.
The names of these things in English, like what the fuck do you mean dump, like I never heard of this in my life. It seems to me like they have, they're more cohesive maybe.
Definitely.
And again, I just, I love, same with our boys, just how encouraging they are to each other. And again, they have this setter that like absolutely hates being any type of like center of attention. He is like very, you know, shy. And so he's like, don't make speeches, please. But like everyone believes in him and everyone is just working together. And I love, I love that they talked about, like, for Kenma, that he pays so much attention to people, and, like, that's, that happens in his personal life. Like, let's say something that might have been brought about because, like, he is shy and socially awkward, and so, like, maybe that can be looked at as some type of, not negative aspect, but just, like, maybe a disadvantage to him in his social life or whatever, but like because of that he's very aware of people and very aware of people's needs and emotions, I think, and he can use that in the court. Like
he's definitely using
pays
that.
Attention, yeah, he pays attention to the people across from net to know how to set up the shot best.
Yeah, honestly, like I really loved that in this episode, how we saw the progress in both teams. Like in the beginning our team was winning because again we had an element of the surprise, and like we have these new players who have some kind of a unique tactic how they're gonna score those points, so like it took the other team Neko like some time like some time to keep up with it and to understand and to realize what the other team is doing, you know. So like they started getting better, you know, and at the end they won a set.
I mean, Kenna basically gave this one guy gave the task of just following Hinata around, just like
because
trying to block him, and the guy kept trying and trying and trying, and it wasn't working. He wasn't fast enough, but at some point he cracked it, and so like he constantly was there in front,
And
but like he continuously worked on it.
But like, so did our guys. Like, that's what coach said. Like, this is just like a practice match. If it was the real match, maybe I would put Hinata like on the bench. But like, because it wasn't, I want to see how they can get better and how they can, what they can do with this new tactic. Like, how Hinata can improve. Like, and he.
I love our coach.
Yeah, me too.
Because like, I mean, it's true. The best way to learn things is by doing them constantly, and it's a good, that's why you have practice matches. You're not like, you don't have to win, you can lose this. Like, the more important thing is to figure out your game. And so he's letting him stay there and continuously get blocked.
Yeah,
but like, but he by didn't. The end he figured something.
I mean, he wasn't discouraged. Like, that was my favorite part of it, because like, everybody expected him to be discouraged, you know, but he just kept trying.
And honestly, like, I thought, just because of how Hinata is and like how much he loves the sport, I thought like this would be good for him. I thought like he would enjoy this, and I love that he enjoyed it, because like, they're competing and both of them are like trying their best. Like, it's not about like, oh, this guy so easily like, he has the height or whatever, and like, they so easily block him. No, like, he is fighting tooth and nail to get to Hinata's hit. It's much more equal, like, they're really battling it out. And for Hinata, again, who has so much love for the game, like, he would love that. Like, he could survive a loss if it was played well, you know, because he loves the sport so much. I adore that. And I adore, as always, I adore Kageyama. But, like, he's so funny. Like, he did a spike. And he is like, he is yelling, but like, he's just showing Hinata like a different type of like spike, where to go like close to the.
No, he loves him. There is no other explanation for it. He loves adores him.
But like, again, he like, this is how you can do this. Like, he's just showing him.
That's what I want to say.
He's like, not like mad at him, just showing him, but he's yelling.
But like, how he shows his love, because like, he wouldn't be yelling if he didn't care. But
like, he even yelled, that goes without question. Of course, I'm gonna give it to you again.
Like, he wants him to get better and to be the best.
He just does not want him to lose. He wants him to live up to his full potential. Yes. And that's all that is.
Yes.
He is the. Kageyama is very fucking sweet.
Yeah.
We said that in the first episode. It is true until now. He is very fucking sweet. But what I also loved is we learned a bit more about Tsuki. Like, similarly to how Kenma is, Tsuki also pays more attention to people. And that's how you see, like, different styles of play. Like, Kageyama, they say he's a genius. Like, he has this natural given talent, you know, that, I mean, of course he works for, you know, he adapts, but like, he has a lot going for him. Hinata is very, how do I call it, he is very just like fast and going and attacking and like hitting hard and whatever, and Tsuki seems like more in the court, he seems like a quieter type where he just pays attention. He pays attention to like where the setter is gonna look. He's not a middle blocker, but like, he pays attention, and that's what helps him in his game. And so I like to learn bits and pieces about, I mean, anyone. And in this episode, was about, like, Tsuki.
Yeah, but it was very small part of the episode. Yeah. But like, immediately when he said like, he's very intelligent or something like that, like, I got very excited, because like, again, Tsuki, for me, from the start, has some type of potential. There is something interesting in him with the way that he behaves and why he talks, how he talks. And there were some like sentences from the start, like, you can speculate on and about, but like, we don't know much about him. But like, in every episode, like, I would want to find out more about him, because again, he has so much potential for me.
Yeah,
very interesting for him.
The most realistic one. I love it every time he says something, like, he makes like a dig, but it's a very funny fucking dig. And I was like, it's okay.
Yeah.
Tsuki, shut up.
Yeah.
I love it.
Me too.
Should we watch the next
episode? The next one is Arrival. Can't wait to watch it. We're gonna play it now.
I wish that we meet again at the finals of some competition. I don't think it's gonna be the first year, you know what I mean? But like, I wish for both of these teams that have like fallen harder times. You know, they had like their glory days. The glory days are over or whatever. I want them both to succeed and like meet at the final of something.
These two teams?
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
I would love them.
Me too. I definitely think that like they're gonna... They are represented, in my opinion. I know we have the previous Okayama or whatever.
Yeah, that's
like,
cool.
I know we have them, but like somehow to me, this team was represented as rivals. You know, like they played in the past, and we found out a lot about their team. And like now we're getting to know character by character them
and
as
they,
well.
They like our guys seem like underdogs.
Yeah,
I mean they say battle the garbage dump.
Yeah, yeah,
you know,
yeah.
Just like
so, like I feel like I'm gonna adore both teams. Like I feel like
I adore
we're gonna
them
definitely.
Already.
Have more of these games.
More games. And again,
definitely.
More teams. And I don't know how much more I can handle. You know what I mean? Like, there's too many people to love.
Yeah, I think there might be even a bit different when it's like a real game versus now when it's practice match. Because, like, I really do have a feeling they're just practicing. Because,
yeah,
like,
because, like, it can be different if you're, like, playing quarterfinals.
Exactly.
And if you lose, you're out.
Yeah. No, that's what I think. I feel like that's gonna be a bigger pressure for them, and like we're gonna feel that pressure and that stress.
At
because
that point,
now
like our coaches
like,
might gonna have to like swap out Hinata if things are not working. You
yeah,
know what I mean?
Like,
I want to
say like now it's like you feel that like it's just a practice match. You feel you see how they're supportive. I think they're gonna be supportive in the future, but like it's gonna be so much more pressure. That like I think it's gonna be a bigger competition than this right here, honestly, because
definitely.
so far in this episode, like I didn't feel like they were competing at all. I literally felt the entire episode like they were learning,
encouraging each other
from each other. You know?
Like that guy across the net that kept blocking Hinata, like when Hinata finally did a spike, I was like, oh my god, it's so amazing.
Exactly.
I've never said that in my fucking life. Like, this is not
I think you're the problem.
I don't think I'm the problem. I was one of the nicer ones on court. You know what I mean?
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Depending on which court.
I didn't know it's that.
I mean, it's not going to kill anyone, but, like, you're not friendly.
You're not friends with them.
I mean, there is no time to be friends with them. Like, you enter the court and you go and they're just there and then you leave. Like,
okay.
It's not...
Okay.
You don't get much time to, like...
Oh, okay, to hang out.
Yeah, no.
Talk.
Basically, like, you're with your team.
Yeah, yeah.
It was much more serious than those club matches.
I'm guessing you're talking about club matches. Because school matches, there is no way you didn't have time to talk to.
We had less time then.
What?
You literally go on a bus... You go on a match, you have like maybe half an hour to warm up.
Interesting.
You play the match.
Interesting.
If you win the match, immediately it's the
next one.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah. The whole competition took
about one day. When it was a camp.
And yeah, then we hang out. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
But like not, there was no time. And also you're like sizing each other up. I don't know.
Really?
Like it was so.
Interesting.
I don't know. You're like, you're trying to figure out who is good at what.
Yeah.
Like, who is a good server, who is a good... And, like, every time I'm on net, because, like, when we were playing, we were very young, no one had a assigned position. So, like, we just rotated. And so, like, you played every position when it came to you.
Point.
Yeah, and, like, I remember... I was wondering that why we didn't see anyone, like, doing the dump so far. But because, like, when I was on net... playing the role of a spiker, of a setter. And I was playing school matches. And depending on who were at my positions for spiking, because like it was a school match, so not everyone was in a club. And depending on who's on my spiker position, I would just go to a dump. Because
they didn't do anything.
Yeah. This was not me being not encouraging. I just like that would not work.
Yeah.
Like that hit would go into the fucking net. And so I did that a lot. And I am tall, and so like it was fine.
Interesting.
And this brings back a lot of memories.
Okay, guys, we're gonna play the next episode now. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you soon. Bye.